Racing to the 2023 Belmont Stakes, and this time let's get an update on the fastest contenders for the 2023 Belmont Stakes. We'll take a look at the Belmont Beyers, the Brisnet speed figure progression, and then we'll also take a look at the track variant. Want to show you how some of these horses run better on faster surfaces. What are some of the days that have had the fastest conducive speed times and speed figure. So let's get to work. The field still has not changed. It looks like we've got a field right of around 12, although I think it's gonna end up at about 10 or 11. I'm not sure Reincarnate is gonna go. Forte still a little bit up in the air depending on how he works back his second work this weekend. So Raise Kane, Tap It Trice, looks like Angel of Empire, National Treasure. Those are ones definitely pointing, along with Hit Show, to the 2023 Belmont Stakes. It looks like Blazing Sevens is not going to run in the Belmont. He is going to run either in the Jim Dandy or the Haskell, or more of a late summer campaign. Now, the Beyer Speed figures to win the Belmont Stakes, anywhere from, you know, really you've got a 107 from Essential Quality all the way down to Mo Donegal's 98 last year. That was one of the slower ones. You had Justify with a 97. Of course, he was kind of tailing off in that Belmont Stakes after a big Derby effort. He regressed in the Preakness and Belmont. Palace Malice with the 106. You know, the key to a good Belmont Stakes performance is really, if you've ran in the Triple Crown, you want to be able to hold your form. But usually, you right around 101, 102 by your speed figure is going to win that Belmont Stakes. This year's field, I don't know, I have a feeling it could be closer to a 100 Beyer. Now, we had a 98 by National Treasure in the Preakness Stakes, and the Kentucky Derby on the Triple Crown Trail this year was a 105 by Mage. That was set up by a fast pace. So that's where I'm saying we had a slow pace for the Preakness, slower number, fast pace for the Derby, a faster number. I think we're going to get more of an honest pace. So I'm looking at, but we've got a little bit overall better talent in the Belmont than we did in the Preakness Stakes. Now, the speed figure chart here is the Brisnet speed figures. And what this shows is by horse in their career, start by start their speed figure progression. So we see in start number one, Kings Barnes had a 95. Then in start number two, he had a 91. In start number three, he maxed out at a 98 in the Louisiana Derby. Now the 76 in the Kentucky Derby was after setting fast fractions, they just kind of eased him up late in the race. So National Treasure coming off a career top 100 Brisnet speed figure in his sixth lifetime race. Remember, most horses will get a new career speed figure top right around starts number 4 to 6. And then normally there's a jump up in start number 3, depending on where their first break was. So horses that I think that can run a new top or a near close top are National Treasure with a 100. Forte could be sitting on a good effort. He had a 103 in the Fountain of Youth, a 100 in the Florida Derby, but he's had a little bit of time off now. Going to be interesting to see how he responds if he runs in the Belmont off a 10-week layoff from missing the Kentucky Derby after running in the Florida Derby. Red Route won with a 94, but he's ran 10 times. So that's where I just don't think he can improve. So they'd have to regress down to a 94. Angel of Empire, after passing on the Preakness, he's sitting right there. A 97, a 101, and a 101. Any one of those three efforts, his last three races, can win the Belmont Stakes. Now, again, what I also look at is the days between races. And what you're looking at here is you want to see a horse that at some point gets a little bit of a break, a 60-day break or longer. That way they can kind of condense their gains, gain some weight, and then get refreshed for a campaign. Angel of Empire is sitting on a good pattern. You know, he had a 67-day break. Then he had a couple of 48-day breaks. He's definitely not been over-raced. Forte had that big break before the Fountain of Youth. Now he's coming in again off a little bit of a mini break after passing on the Derby. Hit Show had a couple of 60-day breaks, 56-day breaks. I think with the turnaround of 28 days from the Wood Memorial to the Kentucky Derby, now he gets 5 weeks off. He could be sitting on a good one. You know, National Treasure had a nice break. He was the morning line favorite for the San Felipe, and he scratched with a foot bruise. Then he did not run in the Derby because he ran fourth in the Santa Anita Derby. So I think he's going to run his race. A couple of horses I think that have been over-raced a little bit. Really no break for Red Route 1. No break for Ray's Kane. So I just don't think they're going to improve to a career top performance. Now, one of the things you want to look at is every racetrack is not the same. And every day at that track is not the same. Some days it's hot and dry and they run more fast. And sometimes it can be a little bit speed favoring. Some days they can kind of tear up the track a little bit, regrade it out between races. So they have what's called a track variant. And this measures the speed of the surface. A low number equals a fast surface. A higher number equals a slow surface. Now, both the Daily Racing Form for their Beyer Speed figures do a track variant. Brisnet does their own track variant. And then even services like Thorograph and Ragazins do track variants. Now, you got to pay to get theirs. Brisnet includes theirs in their files that you can download if you buy the file downloads for the information. Same thing with Daily Racing Form. If you purchase Formulator, you can download the files and then see the track variants. So high number, slow surface, fast number, a low number, a fast surface. So what I do here is I took kind of the key contenders, the big five, I'm going to call them, for the Belmont Stakes, Angel of Empire. I took just their 2023 races. So what this shows in the Kentucky Derby on April 6th, and their starts start at the top. So their most recent start is at the bottom. So Kentucky Derby Day had a very fast surface, an 8. That's lower than a 10. Anytime you get lower than a 10, it means it was a very fast surface. And another surface that was very fast was Preakness Day. That had a track variant of 4. So Angel National Treasure ran on a fast surface on Preakness Day. And if you notice, he had a 0 track variant on the Sham Stakes Day. That was a very fast surface as well. The speed figure came back high, but they haven't been able to replicate that speed figure because Reincarnate, that was his best race of the year. A lot of times, very fast, very fast racetracks, low number variants can produce fast times and be kind to front runners. Now, the reason why I'm showing is this is that Tappet Trice ran on a fast surface in Tampa Bay, ran on a fast surface in the Derby. I think a horse like Tappet Trice will like a slower variant, a slower surface. So a grinding style. You know, on February the 4th, he ran at Gulfstream. That was a little bit slower surface, a 16, and he ran one of his better races. And in the Bluegrass had a 11 variant. He ran one of his better races. Hit Show, this just shows you the variant in Aqueduct over the wintertime. They bring in a bunch of sand. A 30 variant on Hit Show on the Withers Stakes. That's why the time was very slow. But sometimes horses just like slower surfaces. Forte, he's ran on a couple of fast surfaces this year. So these things are things that I look at. I want to know if they ran on a fast surface. You know, I think Angel of Empires ran on a more even surface over his last three races. And he really never really got going in the Derby because I think it may have just been too fast of a surface for him. Now, the late pace numbers, we still got King's Barn with that 109 in the Louisiana Derby. They ran fast early that day, slow late. National Treasure and Tappet Trice with the 107. And then you've got Forte did get a 106 in that Fountain of Youth. That was a big effort off the layoff. He may have regressed a little bit in the Florida Derby. I think he could bounce back here in the Kentucky Derby if he trains well. So that is a look at the Belmont field for 2023 on the speed figure scale. We still got a lot more to dive into. We'll be taking a look at pedigree, be taking a look at some of the top contenders, some of the trip notes, how they got those speed figures. Remember, it's not the number they get, it's how they got that number. What do you think of the speed figures for the Belmont Stakes? Leave a comment. The Belmont Racing Festival, June 8th through the 10th. Belmont Stakes Day just around the corner on June 10th as we get you ready. Don't forget our updates for May 24th. We took a look at some of the runners in the Belmont Racing Festival, and Forte confirmed for a field of 11 on Monday. And as D. Wayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.